Getting started with GoldenGate Cloud Service involves these main tasks. Creating SSH keys so that I can securely connect to my new virtual machines. Creating a storage container in Oracle Storage Cloud Service for database backups. Creating a service instance in Oracle Database Cloud Service to host the replicated data. Creating a service instance in GoldenGate Cloud Service to perform data integration and replication. And finally, exploring the GoldenGate Cloud Service console for service information. For some of these tasks, I'll need my Oracle Cloud Identity domain, as well as the name and password of a user in this identity domain. First, I'll create my SSH keys. SSH keys come in pairs and consist of a public key and a private key. Later, when I provision my VMs in the Oracle Cloud, I'll supply the public key. Then if I ever need to access my VMs from a command line, I simply connect with the private key. If I'm on Windows, I'll use PuTTY to create my pair of keys. SSH keys can include an optional description, and the private key can also be password protected. First, I export the private key as a file. And then I copy and paste the public key text into a separate file. On the other hand, I'm on a Unix platform, or if I'm running a Unix emulator on Windows, like Cygwin, I'll use the SSH keygen utility. Next, I need to create a storage container in the Oracle Public Cloud. Oracle Storage Cloud is administered through REST APIs. I'll create my container by using curl, a popular command line REST client tool that's included in most Unix distributions and is also available for Windows. The first REST request establishes a session for my Oracle Cloud user. The response includes an authentication token value. I'll add this token to my next REST request, which creates the actual storage container in the Oracle Cloud. GoldenGate Cloud Service requires a running database for hosting its replicated data. So next, I'll create a service instance in Oracle Database Cloud Service. Be sure to select the database as a service option. When I create a database cloud service instance, I can choose from several different billing options and software releases. I also choose an appropriate compute shape to meet the workload I expect on this service instance. An Oracle compute shape defines the amount of virtual CPUs and RAM that is available to the VMs in this service instance. Here, I provide the SSH public key file that I generated earlier. This will enable me to remotely log into the database VM by using the matching private key file. I'll pay particular attention to the database administrative password. I'll need to know it when I create my GoldenGate Cloud Service instance. The Oracle Cloud automatically backs up data from my database instances, and older backups are automatically moved to my storage container. I simply need to provide the fully qualified name of my new storage container along with the credentials I used to create it. After my new database instance is provisioned and running, I can move on to the next task. Now I'm ready to create a service instance in the GoldenGate Cloud Service. First, I need to name my new GoldenGate Cloud Service and give it a proper business description, so later on my coworkers can also identify it. I provide the name of the same public key file I created earlier so that I'll be able to remotely log into my GoldenGate Cloud VM by using the matching private key file. Before I create my service, the wizard shows me the version of GoldenGate that I'll get on my virtual machine. Next, I need to name my replication service VM. I focus my description on the source and target databases. I also select a compute shape that meets the workload requirements of my replication. The replication VM needs the connection information to the target database. I select the database cloud service instance that I created earlier and supply the credentials to connect to this database. Now my new GoldenGate Cloud Service is being provisioned and I can periodically check its status. After my new GoldenGate Cloud Service instance is up and running, I can access its details. For example, I might need to find the name of the replication database service instance. Or I may want to copy the public IP address of this VM so my source database can connect to this instance. On this page, I can find any detail I need for my service instance. In summary, I use my GoldenGate Cloud Service Console to create new services, search for existing ones, review failed instances, and delete any unwanted ones. Thanks for watching this video about getting started with Oracle GoldenGate Cloud Service. A companion tutorial is also available that documents all the steps I just presented. Welcome to Oracle Cloud.